Local engineer John Peters is joining calls for the government and city planners to ensure that urban spaces are expanded in more equitable and sustainable ways. With a continuing trend toward urban migration, he says this is not only important but critical.
As a young man growing up in the 70s, the predominant discourse at the time related to apartheid in South Africa, inequality of black people within the Caribbean, and that shaped the conversation even among the young people at the time. I was a young student, I think I was in Form 5 at the age of 14, and had vigorous debates on those issues. And it was because those were the issues that were framed within the society as pertinent and important.
Mr. Peters says while there may be other pertinent matters affecting our society, the issue of climate change should be on the front burner. As a small island developing state, which is vulnerable to natural disasters, he believes regional counterparts should continue forming partnerships to confront similar challenges.
What we have today in our society, unfortunately, is a conversation about who is a thief and who is a bigger thief. All right? And when you have that as the principal discourse that exists within our society, we have a problem. We in the Caribbean, because of our size, because of our vulnerability, not only to natural disasters such as that which come from climate change, but we also have volcanoes, we have landslides. We in fact are, in terms of natural vulnerability, some of the highest in the world.
The engineer made reference to a recent study conducted by the IMF highlighting the significant economic decline which cities have experienced. The issue was also raised this week during an OECS-organized summit. Mr. Peters implores relevant stakeholders to be proactive and provide young persons with the avenues necessary so they can contribute to sustainable development.
Caribbean countries are losing, on average, 5% of their GDP every year when it is evened out in terms of the losses that we incur because of the issues of climate change. So it is a real discourse that has to be taken into account in the society. And it starts with those that are leaders framing the discussions so that young people can begin to participate, because they are the ones that we're going to face it. We all going to be out of here very soon. And they are the ones that will have to face the consequences of that climate change.
Mr. Peter focused in on the urgent reconstruction of communities near the shoreline. He encourages OECS stakeholders to continue having dialogue with member states to remedy the situation.
I'm glad you spread it out into a regional context, because we, as a country alone, cannot deal with the issues in isolation. And you're correct that the conversation has to move into a regional level. The engagement with the young people also has to move in that direction. And maybe we need to look at this as a regional issue, as against an isolated country-based and specific issue that we have to deal with.
The engineer encourages the Housing Ministry and Department of Infrastructure to enforce climate-resilient building codes so that infrastructure can withstand predicted weather events. For the DBS News World, Manasseh Stanislaus reporting.